do some inking. New pen. Get that new pen strength. And hopefully that new pen look. Alright, let's do this. Time to get some inking done. So yeah, open mic. Motif. Can't wait to get back out to playing them again. Hope everybody is safe and well. I'm picturing him singing Hello My Baby. I don't know about y'all. But I think that would be with like a deep voice. Hello my baby. Like a rock ragtimeian kind of voice. Hello my baby. Hello my heart. One of them kind of things. And then maybe his jawbone falls off as he's doing that and he picks it up. And then he little skedaddles his way off stage, you know. Why not? That's the way to do it. That's what I see in my head. Not all the time, but in this particular drawing. Hope everybody's doing well. This is a Washington Red or Washington football team stick, I guess. That's what this is. Cane. Like the old. This is like a vaudeville thing? Clowns pulling people off stages? I know it was on like Showtime at the Apollo. But I think that's a lot older than that. I think that's like, probably goes back to the 20s or something. I don't know. There's a thing called Wikipedia. It probably has an answer to that, but I don't know the answer to that. This isn't the most fact-based drawing. These teams are playing each other this weekend coming up. That is a fact. But other than that, I can't give any other accurate information. Maybe that was like the Warner Brothers frog that did that? And maybe it might have been. I think there was a Warner Brothers frog that did that. I know there's a really good cartoon with a frog that like a guy finds and the frog dances and like does all sorts of stuff and then he like tries to show people that this frog can do that and then every time the frog does not do that for other people so he looks like he's crazy. Yeah, it's a pretty funny cartoon. I don't remember if that was a Looney Tune or something. Probably was a Looney Tune, but it was like a one-off. Gurr. You know what? I'm gonna give a Miss Pac-Man on this. He's a raider. Lives in Vegas, so he likes strip clubs. Alright, the Casey. Actually, you know what? Let's go crazy with this. Stupid. I hope I don't offend anybody with that. I think it's pretty funny. Yeah, 180 this thing totally. Instead of laughing, they'll be having a beauty heart attack. Maybe Stabler. Well, I definitely did need a new pen. This is working a whole lot better. So that's good. If I get solid lines from the pen, I believe that makes the photoshopping go significantly easier. So that's good to know. Hopefully you guys are getting a good picture. I'm struggling to figure out the best way to get the lighting on these, right? But in time, I'll figure it out. Actually, this helmet thing works pretty well for that. I went to a Titan game with my mom once, and the Raiders played there. She's a big Raider OG. And I had a blast, man. That was cool. Cool experience. They treat people right there. That was cool. Hard to believe the Titans are dominating the Rams without having Derrick Henry. I would say he's like one of the top, I don't know, maybe top five players in the league. Like really, he's like, his whole offense ran behind him, and now they just, yeah. Picking Tannehill up from the Dolphins was a really good decision. Crazy it didn't work out in Miami. With that guy. It's pretty cool. Dallas wore their bicentennial helmets over the weekend with the red, white, and blue stripe as opposed to just the blue and white stripe that's on their helmet, down their helmet. They wore those in 1976 for the bicentennial of America. And those are sharp looking jerseys. The away jersey from that time is really cool. Surprised they don't go back to that blue. It's a much lighter blue. More of a, I guess, royal blue. That is nice. As opposed to a navy blue. Oops. Man, stars are hard to draw. Golly. They get me every time. That's unfortunate because it's almost done, but I have got to take a bathroom break.